Folks, we're about 2 to 3 minutes out. Just one announcement. This aisle on this side here, just
we go over some rights that you have, some court procedures, and also fine. And that is whether or not you're going to get a bond, and if so, what it's going to be. Sir, you feeling all right today? Excuse me, can you speak up?
Yes, sir.
Okay. I just want to make sure you understand where you are. You understand where you are today?
Yes, sir.
Where are you today? Where are you now? Do you know where you are?
Yes, sir.
Where?
Court.
Okay. All right. So, the bond court, you just set a bond. Do you know why we set bonds in bond court? That's to make sure, the number one reason we set bond in bond court is to make sure that you appear and come to court. Okay? Now, the charges against you, there are several charges in the county, and they're very serious. You've got 6 counts of attempted murder, 1 count of murder, and 1 count of possession of weapon during a violent crime. Do you understand these charges against you? Has anyone explained them to you? These are very, very serious charges. They range from penalty from 5 years, 30 years, up to life, and even the possibility of death penalty. That's how serious these matters are. You understand that?
Yes, sir.
Now, I'm going to review some of your rights with you. Now, you have to come to court. If you do not come to court, if you are released for any reason and you do not come to court, do you know what happens if you don't come to court? Well, the trial could go on without you. You could be found guilty. There could be another order for your arrest. Charges could be additional charges, additional penalties. So it's a very serious matter that you have to prepare in court. And we'll go over, you're going to have several different court dates to come. Okay? Now, when you come to court, you have the right to have an attorney. If you cannot afford an attorney, you have the right to have, you have the right to go and see you apply and qualify for a public defender. Now, right now, you're being represented by a public defender. I'm not sure if that's going to take you through the trial or whether you're going to apply, but you need to know. You have the right to apply for a public defender's office. Your third choice is to show up to court without an attorney. It's very risky, especially for these kind of charges. We don't recommend it, but I need to tell you, you have a written right to do so. Do you understand that? Do you understand everything I've been saying so far? I'm not quite sure you're following everything I'm saying. Sir? Can you speak up?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Do you understand? Do you have any questions so far what we've discussed?
No, sir.
Okay. Are you feeling okay?
Yes, sir.
Sir?
Yes, sir.
Now, you also have the right for what's called a preliminary hearing. Preliminary hearing is a probable cause hearing. There you get to have a hearing to decide whether or not there is enough probable cause for this matter to, these matters to go forward to a trial. Do you understand that? You have a right to ask for a preliminary hearing. Your attorneys will advise you on that. Okay? You have the right to ask for either a bench trial or a jury trial. So do you know the difference between a bench trial and a jury trial? Sir? Do you know the difference between a bench trial and a jury trial? Okay. Bench trial is where just the judge, you come before the judge, and we have a trial with just the judge. A jury trial is like what you see on the TV, the jurors will decide on your case. You get to choose. By consulting with your attorneys, you will inform the court of which you choose, and you do so before the trial begins. Okay? Any questions so far? You have a right to ask for an expungement of these charges if you are found innocent, not guilty, at the trial. So if any of these charges are found not guilty, the court will then clear these charges off your record. Do you follow that? Also, if you are released at any point in time, you also have a duty to inform the court of any change of contact information, address, or phone number. Okay? Do you have any questions about what we've done so far? Do your attorneys have any questions so far?
Yes, sir.
Hey, Your Honor, just to address, Ms. Bowen and I spoke with him at the jail this morning before the bond hearing to advise him of the unique nature of this situation. I think he is still a little bit nervous about the obvious differences that we would normally have in a bond hearing.
Right. Well, normally a bond court would take place in a very small room. Now, a registered courthouse is not necessarily in a big room like this. But I'm always concerned, though, that the defendant is aware of what's going on, and I'm concerned, I'm hoping that the attorneys are aware of his condition and whether or not he's...
We have no concerns based on our conversation this morning.
All right. Well, in that case, what I have is I have some documents I need for him to sign off on, which is basically a review of what we just went over. Okay? Can you read and write, sir? This first document, sir, is a checklist. This is the review, summarizes what we just went over, all the different rights. And I've circled some X's on the left-hand side. There should be four X's. If you would please put your initials next to those four circled X's.
Yeah, maybe sit down.
You can sit down. Address each one of those items just now. When you're finished marking those four circled X's, I'd like you to turn the page over to the back side. And in the middle of the page on the left-hand side is the place for your signature. You will get a copy of everything that you signed, so you can review it later. And right above your signature is the first court date. We're going to get another document which we'll go over to review all your court dates. Okay? The next document is a review of what we discussed about your rights to have an attorney. sheet is a list of all your court dates. First appearance, second appearance, third appearance, and the preliminary hearing. The next document is your request to have the preliminary hearing. So to bring that to the clerk. Thank you. Do you have any questions so far to this point, sir? Okay. What I'd like to do at this point for the sentence, I'd like to anybody that's involved in this case, is something we'd like to say. So the first one turns to the attorneys. Is there anything you'd like to say with respect to the setting of the bond?
You know, I think by statute you are unable to set bond on the murder charge, so we will proceed with that and go forward with the general sessions hearing at the appropriate time.
Thank you. Does the solicitor's office have anything they'd like to say?
Yeah, the court is still at 5 for the following session, 22:55 p.m. and defer bond. We would ask the bond be deferred on all charges, not just murder.
Okay, thank you. And is there anybody else in the victim advocates here on the county cases who wish to say anything? Have you heard on the aspect of the bond? Based on the seriousness of these charges, 6 different attempted murders, 1 possession of a weapon during a violent crime, and 1 charge of murder. These are very serious charges. And statute requires, especially since there has been some flight in this matter this past week, and that the bond on all charges will be denied. And that is my thoughts. Any questions? Right. I'm just going to sign off. All right, thank you very much. Unless there's something else, this matter is concluded, and the Chester Municipal Court, which I probably will then proceed.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Good afternoon, I'm Judge Wilder and I am representing the city of Chester on the charges. And as Judge Garrett has already stated, who's in attendance, so I will go on with my bond hearing. Mr. Terry. I'm going to go over your rights and then I will charge you. You have the right and obligation to be present at your trial. The trial will go on in your absence. And if you fail to show up, a bench warrant will be issued for your arrest. You do have the right to an attorney, if you can't afford an attorney, which I'm sure you've already been appointed attorney. The city will appoint one for you. You have the right to represent yourself. However, I must warn you that self-representation can be dangerous. There may be certain things about your case that you don't understand, and it will be to how to appropriately address them before the court and for the jury in order to be a valid review. Now, if you represent yourself, the court is going to treat you accordingly, and you will be responsible for applying all the rules of the court to include procedural rules, your behavior before the judge or and the jury. You do have the right to hire an attorney at your own expense. You have the right to a preliminary hearing for testimony explained to you earlier. You have the right to a jury trial. Now, the charges that are brought against you are non-cross, so you're found not guilty or they're dismissed, then they will be responsible for your record. The charges you're facing with the city of Chester, you're facing one count of burglary plus first degree, which carries a sentence of life of 15 years of up to life, and which is also a felony. Three counts of pointing and presenting, which is punished by 5 years. Unlawful carrying of a pistol, punished by $1,000 for 1 year. 5 counts of attempted murder, which carries a sentence of up to 30 years. 2 counts, which are municipal charges, malicious injury to property. Those charges carry a $1,000 fine or 30 days in jail, although those are, you know, outstanding charges. Sir, on all the charges that you're facing with the city of Chester, this afternoon, sir, I am denying bond on all charges, sir. Okay. Now, I have sent the forms that I release you to initially. And the first one would be your rights that you have as a defendant. And the second form will be the right to a preliminary hearing. And the third form will be your joint session court date. You understand that, sir? Okay. Yeah, anyway. The addition number two, which states that I did inform you what you're being charged with. Number three, I did inform you that you have a right to a preliminary hearing. I also need you to check the block below as I informed you both orally and in writing. Number four, I did inform you that you have a right to a trial by jury. Number five, I did go over your legal rights, which means your right to legal representation. Then the signature, sir. The second form, sir, is just additional information regarding your rights. I'm not saying that you're aware of your rights, but I did go over your rights with you. Third form is your request for a preliminary hearing. Lastly, will be your court dates, which I have underlined all your court dates, your first appearance, your second appearance, your third appearance, and your preliminary hearing date.
My name is Jerry Robinson, and I thank you for denying this bond, but I just want to let him know that I forgive for what he done to me, and may God just have mercy on his life. Thank you.
Mr. Terry, did you do that? There aren't any more questions for him from the prosecution or the defense to the defense or any other attorney. This includes the bond hearing. Tyler Terry.
Thank you.
Thank you.